this black waiter had been serving a disabled woman for years, building a quiet but meaningful connection. One day, she handed him her keys along with an astonishing note that would change his life forever. That afternoon, the diner was filled with the usual lunch crowd, buzzing with conversation. When Ella left, James went to clean her table and was surprised to find her car keys instead of a small tip. There was a note with them, quickly hidden under the keys. James took them, thinking Ella must have left them by mistake. When James read the note later, it wasn't just any message. It had an address written in Ella's shaky handwriting with no other details. James was puzzled. Was this a request for help or something else? The mystery of it made him want to find out more. Things like this didn't happen in James's area. It almost felt like the beginning of a thriller. James lived in a small coastal town. He worked as a dedicated black waiter who had been serving customers at the local diner for many years. This diner was a beloved spot in the town. Ella, the customer who left the keys, was an older lady who was quite a mystery and lived a quiet life due to her disability. She visited the diner so regularly, you could almost set your watch by her routine. By the day, something unusual happened that James didn't see coming. After work, James drove to the address, which turned out to be an old beach house that looked like no one had lived there for years. The front house was unlocked, and it creaked loudly as he opened it. Inside, the house was covered in dust and dimly lit, but you could tell it once had a lot of life. The biggest surprise came when James found old movie posters featuring a young woman who looked just like Ella. James was stunned to learn that Ella, the quiet regular at the diner, used to be a famous actress in the old days of movies. It was surprising and intriguing. Why would she hide such an exciting past? While he was thinking about this, he suddenly heard footsteps upstairs, which was creepy because the house seemed empty. With his heart racing, James carefully walked up the stairs, the old wood creaking with each step. At the top, he found an old projector that suddenly turned on by itself, throwing shaky images on the wall. The film showed clips from Ella's movies mixed with personal moments from her life that weren't meant for public. It was like watching pieces of a puzzle he hadn't yet solved. Just then, a strong wind slammed the window shut, making James jump and quickly turn off the projector. The room went dark, and that's when he spotted a light-colored envelope hiding under a loose floorboard. Inside were letters Ella had written but never sent, talking about her wish to fix things with a daughter she had lost touch with because of past decisions. This revelation showed the sad parts of Ella's life, contrasting sharply with her past fame. James thought about whether he should return the keys and talk about what he found, but that would invade the privacy she seemed to really want. The secrets that were now sort of shared between them felt heavy. James figured out that Ella leaving the keys was probably on purpose, maybe her way of trying to make one last connection before it was too late. As James walked away from the beach house, the keys felt heavier than before. He knew things at the diner and his chats with Ella wouldn't be the same. When he got back to the diner, which usually felt like a cozy, familiar place, it now seemed oddly quiet, almost as if it could sense the changes in James's life. Wanting to understand what was really going on, James decided to dig deeper into Ella's past, especially after her strange way of reaching out. The next day, with a sense of responsibility mixed with curiosity, James headed to the local library to look up more about Ella's career as an actress. He went through old newspapers and movie magazines, and suddenly, he found an article that shocked him. It talked about a young actress who disappeared just as her career was taking off, leaving a movie unfinished. The actress looked just like Ella, but the name was different. This clue made James wonder if Ella had changed her identity to escape some bad experiences in her past. This new information drove him to go back to the beach house, hoping to find more answers. But this time, the front door that had been open before was now locked tight. However, James didn't give up. He walked around the house and spotted a small rusty key hidden in the bushes, which luckily worked on the back door. Inside, the house had a different vibe, as if it knew its secrets were slowly being uncovered. James went up to the attic, and using his flashlight, he found a locked trunk. The same key opened it, and inside, he discovered a bunch of old film reels and a worn-out diary. The diary written by Ella detailed her quick rise to fame and her sudden decision to step away from it all because of a scandal that put her in danger. As James was reading Ella's personal writings, something else caught his eye. Tucked between the pages of the diary was a faded photo of Ella with a young girl, labeled on the back as her niece, the only family member Ella really trusted. This photo gave James a new idea. Maybe the address Ella had left them was not just about her past, but was actually a clue to where her niece might be now. Feeling more determined, James decided to find this niece, hoping she could help him understand more about what Ella wanted and why she was tied to that old beach house. His search took him to a nearby town where the niece used to own a small bookstore. But when he got there, he found out that the bookstore had changed owners because the niece had moved away years ago. Not giving up, James talked to the new owner, who remembered the niece well and mentioned she had moved to a city just a few hours away. Now James had to make a choice. Should he dig deeper into Ella's family secrets, or should he respect the privacy she seemed to value so much? Choosing to follow the clue Emma had left them, James headed toward the city. As evening began to fall, he got to the address he had been given, his heart racing with the thoughts of what he might discover. The house in front of him was well kept, nothing like the rundown beach house. As he walked up to the front door, he braced himself for what was waiting inside. What he was about to find would be the biggest surprise yet, a revelation that would link his life with Ella's in ways he never could have imagined. He pressed the doorbell, his heart thumping almost as loudly as the bell itself. The door swung open and there stood a woman in her early 50s, looking so much like Ella that James was taken aback for a moment. Before he could even say who he was, the woman, picking up on why he was there, gave him a knowing nod, recognizing the connection they both had to Ella. This warm yet mysterious welcome was just the beginning of a day full of unexpected truths. The woman introduced herself as Marie, Ella's niece, and invited James inside. As they sat down for tea, Marie started to explain the complicated past of her aunt. She shared that Ella wasn't just a famous actress. She had also been caught up in a scandal so dangerous that it forced her to go into hiding and change her identity to keep herself and her family safe. While James was trying to grasp the depth of Marie's story, she handed him a faded letter that Ella had written but never actually sent to him. The letter detailed why Ella had to leave everything, including her rising career and her dear niece. Marie had found the letter among Ella's things and kept it hidden because it was too hard to share. But there was more to come. Marie took James to an old study and pulled a book from the shelf that looked ordinary but was actually hollowed out. Inside it were some papers and a small digital recorder. When James played the recorder, he heard Ella's voice a bit crackly from time, expressing her fear that someone from the past was still out to find her even after so many years. Hearing Ella's voice made the seriousness of the situation really hit James. It wasn't just a scandal that had haunted the actress. She had been constantly running from real danger, a threat that might still be out there. Discovering this message made James wonder if it was even safe to keep digging into Ella's secrets. Marie, seeing how worried James was, admitted she too was scared that the peaceful last few years were just a brief break. She mentioned that odd things had started happening again around the time Ella began showing up at the diner where James worked. This suggested that whoever or whatever Ella was hiding from might have found her there. This new info made James think about the effects of his snooping. He had accidentally put Ella in more danger by poking around in her past. The thought weighed heavily on him as he left Marie's house, the setting sun casting long shadows that seemed to mirror his troubled thoughts. Driving back to the diner, James was deep in thought, reflecting on a world that now seemed as changed and full of hidden meanings as his own life had become. The secrets Marie revealed didn't just add layers to Ella's mystery. They pulled him deeper into a story he hadn't expected to be a part of. With the diner feeling like his second home, James thought about buying it, but money was tight and it looked pretty tough to gather enough to make the purchase. He was lost in these thoughts until a chat with a bank manager who often visited the diner gave him a hint of hope. The manager knew James well and respected him. He mentioned a special loan program for local businesses that might make James's dream to own the diner more possible than he had thought. Just as James started to feel hopeful about his future, he hit another bump. The real estate agent told him that a big company wanted to buy the diner to tear it down and build something new. This news shocked James and kicked him into gear. He knew he had to move fast and make some big moves if he wanted to save the place. While he was figuring out what to do next, James got a worrying call from Marie. She was really upset, telling him that someone had broken into her house. It seemed like the troubles from the past weren't over, and she urged James to be careful. This made James even more determined to keep safe what Ella had left behind and to fight harder for the diner, a place full of their memories. James didn't waste any time. He rallied the community, holding meetings and even organizing rallies to keep the diner. He talked about how important the diner was to the town's vibe and history, and soon local newspapers and TV stations were covering the story. The community's response was strong, and people really started to push back against the idea of the corporate takeover. Then, just when he needed it most, something unexpected happened. A mysterious person who had learned about James' dedication decided to help out. This anonymous donor promised to match whatever money James could raise, giving him the boost he needed to make a competitive offer for the diner. Winning the bid to buy the diner wasn't just about keeping the business going. It was also about preserving a piece of the town's history and honoring Ella's legacy. James decided to set up a small area in the diner as a mini gallery, showing off memorabilia from Ella's acting days, like photos and the film reels from the beach house. With the diner under James's care, it started to thrive, becoming both the popular spot for a meal and a tribute to Ella. As he got ready for the big reopening, everyone was excited, but then James hit a snag. The diner's original recipes, which were a big part of its charm, were nowhere to be found. The problem cast a shadow over the upcoming celebrations. Determined to fix this, James went back to the beach house, hoping he might have missed something before that could help. While digging around Ella's old stuff again, he discovered a hidden drawer in her desk. Inside, there it was, the original recipe book. Dusted, but all in one piece. Finding this book was perfect timing. It meant that the food at the grand reopening would be as authentic as ever, and it made James feel even closer to Ella, realizing how her past actions were still shaping the diner's future. The grand reopening was a huge success, drawing people from all over town and even some from further away. During the event, James noticed an older man who seemed a bit out of place, lingering around the memorabilia. Curious, James went over to chat. The man turned out to be a retired detective who had worked on the case that forced Ella to hide away. He shared that the danger to Ella had actually been gone for years, and her staying hidden was more out of old habits and fear than anything else. This new piece of information gave James a fresh burst of motivation. He was more determined than ever to keep Ella's memory alive and make the diner a beacon in the community. And then, just when things couldn't get more interesting, James got an incredible surprise. He found a letter from the detective that had been left behind by mistake, revealing a bank account Ella had set up in James's name, filled with money from her movie residuals. This unexpected money meant that James could do even more for the diner and start new projects for the community, keeping Ella's spirit alive in bigger ways. Right in the middle of all this, Marie showed up at the diner out of the blue, adding another twist to the story. She brought a bunch of letters from Ella that she had hidden away because she was afraid they'd bring back painful memories. These letters meant for James and the town shared Ella's hopes for forgiveness and her wish to fix the past mistakes. During the celebration, James shared these letters with everyone there, creating a really touching moment that helped heal old hurts and brought everyone closer together. As the day was winding down, yet another surprise happened. A film crew arrived, drawn by the tale of the diner's makeover and its connection to Ella's film career. They wanted to make a documentary about Ella's life, the impact she had on the town, and how James was keeping her memory alive. This was a chance to share her story with a lot more people. As the documentary started to take shape, James found himself in the spotlight, a new experience he was learning to handle with both excitement and a bit of nervousness. But then another unexpected thing started happening. Letters began arriving at the diner from all over the country. They were from people saying how much Ella's movies or her secret acts of kindness had meant to them during her years away from the public eye. These letters, filled with personal tales and thanks, showed that Ella had touched many more lives than anyone had guessed. Fascinated by how far-reaching Ella's influence was, James suggested a new direction for the documentary. They should follow these letters to their origins and share the stories of the people Ella had helped. The film crew loved this idea, and the project grew into a bigger exploration of how one person's life can leave a lasting mark in the most unexpected ways. As they were planning to travel for the documentary, another big surprise came up. During a chat with the director, James was shown a manuscript Ella had written but never published. It was a sort of fictional story of her life, mixing real events with a made-up character who faced her challenges head-on instead of hiding from them. This manuscript showed a side of Ella that was completely different from the quiet life everyone knew. Feeling a deep respect for this new discovery, James and the documentary team decided to weave parts of Ella's manuscript into the film. They used it as a connecting thread through the different stories they were going to capture. This added a really deep artistic and emotional layer to the film, turning it from just a documentary into a powerful exploration of identity, bravery, and the power of stories. Then, just as they were wrapping up the film, another twist occurred. A woman reached out to James, claiming to be Ella's long-lost daughter. She had lost touch with Ella after a scandal that ruined her career and had only found out about her mother's past and what she had been up to afterwards because of the buzz the documentary was creating. Her return sparked a new chapter of making amends and healing, not just for her family but also for the community that had come to love Ella without fully knowing her complex story. Thanks for sticking with us through this tale. I hope you found it as captivating as we did. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments, and if this story moved you, don't forget to hit that like button.